Graham's first season of bedding in at Leeds United, the Elland Road faithful were looking for a vast improvement, both in results and in terms of excitement. The manager's early concentration on improving the defence had earned Leeds safety in the Premiership, but as the division's lowest scoring team, it was clear where his priorities lay for the new campaign.
Sometimes the target is probably overrides, you know, the entertainment value. And last year, the target was survival in the Premiership. And I thought we'd probably go into the last few weeks of the season, you know, still in the relegation battle. But we actually escaped it by 2 months. So I was pleased with the result, but obviously the performances left a little bit to be desired.
In the close season, there have been talk of glamorous big money signings, but Graham's ventures into the transfer market were comparatively modest. Most lavish was the purchase for a reported £3 million of Crystal Palace's David Hopkin, whose Wembley goal had sent the Eagles soaring into the Premiership. From the relative obscurity of the Portuguese league came Bruno Ribeiro and Jimmy Floyd Hasselbank.
I know Leeds is a big club and a big city, and they have many things to do in the future, so I want to be part of it.
What's your feeling about English supporters? You've probably heard this and that along the way, what terrible types there are and so on.
No, that's not true. I didn't hear nothing that they are terrible types. I know that I've heard that the Leeds United fans are very, very mad and very much singing, and I like that. So I'm looking forward to play for them.
Now, they will also make demands. You're a newcomer, they'll be looking. Can you live with that?
Of course, they are paying my wages, so they have to. I'm doing all in my power to make myself succeed and to play well for them and make a spectacle for them on the pitch and winning games with the other 10 guys. I know there is pressure, but there's everywhere pressure.
From Celtic, David Robertson. And from relegated Nottingham Forest, Norwegian international Alf Inge Haaland.
Looking forward to a new club, and I think it's a bigger club. And you know, we struggled with Forest last year, but I think we're going to do well with Leeds this season.
More than 3 years in this country now, do you feel you've really sort of established yourself, or was it one way or another hard work at Nottingham?
It's hard work in the start, but you know, I settled down very quickly. I think I like the country, you know, the English people, and hopefully the Yorkshire people will treat me as good as the Midlanders do.
I'm sure they will. You're doubtless aware of Leeds's historic reputation.
Oh yeah, the Tetley Brewery and all those other things.
Well, not so much that. I meant Leeds players of the 60s and 70s.
I'm just joking. Yeah, of course, they've got brilliant records, you know, from the past. But hopefully, it's one of the clubs who's done well in the 90s as well, where they, you know, they won the championship in 92. So, you know, hopefully we can repeat that sometime.
Added to Graham's signings late in the previous season, Pierre Laurent and Derek Lilly, these were imaginatively dubbed the Magnificent Seven. But some remain to be convinced of their worth.